Good morning, everyone. This is day 13, Fortunate Son. Let's hope that's not bad luck. I think it'll be good luck, though. It's raining here in Los Angeles. I love riding in the rain in Los Angeles and listening to it outside the door and windows. So that's exciting, and we need lots of rain, too. So we're entering into the end game. I think I've said that before in various different ways, but this is the end of the end game, where it's sort of a large and maybe fairly spectacular scene, and it brings all of the threads that we've been building together. I don't have a ton to say about it at the start, but when I get done with it, I'll be back, and I think I'll have quite a lot to say. So for now, I'm just going to get started, and I'm going to go for it, and I'm going to make a run for the end. All right, here we go. See you shortly. I Thank you. Okay. Well, there we go. We made the final charge. We have reached the end. But I will not type the end, of course, because this is a very, very rough structural draft. I'm going to, next week, beginning on Monday. I always like to end writing a script on a Friday so that I can sort of regroup and Monday attack it all over again. But Monday I'll start at the beginning and then I will go through the process of I intend to make this come to life. And that means I will fill in the gaps that are there. I know, for instance, that the protagonist, I lost sight to some small degree, lost sight of his humanity when I changed the point of view of his humanity. And there's one or two small scenes that I need to add in. And I'm just going to go in and I'm going to make it pretty. I'm going to write it more economically. I'm going to write it better. The dialogue will sharpen, be sharpened significantly. You'll see, I think, though, I could be wrong, I reserve the right to be wrong, but you'll see that the structure remains largely 90 to 99% the same as it currently is. And now the process, and it's about to become, what I just did is difficult. And I have to be honest, it was very difficult in this process with having a camera on it, because I've never done that before. And I felt as though it made me less agile, I was not as fast, and I was self-conscious writing, which is bad because I really believe in sort of connecting with your unconscious when you write. Don't think, just write. And in this case, I felt the sort of secondary presence of someone watching me, which was not you, it was me watching me write, which was just weird. So it wasn't pleasant. But, you know, this is the heavy lifting. We've got it done. We framed the house. So now I'm going to go back. Next week I'll get really, really depressed. This always happens because I go back and I'm like, I don't like this. I don't like this. It won't be that I don't like the structure. It's just that I have to, now that I've written the scenes and I know that each scene fulfills its necessity structurally in terms of getting me from point B to point B, A to point B, point A to point B, and in a way that is fundamentally interesting, but it needs reworking to really make it work, to make it sing. And it's an aggregate affair, and over the aggregate you'll see, I believe, that this thing will start gaining life, will start gaining life. And so this first draft, this first very rough draft, is quite difficult, because again, there's a lot of heavy lifting. A lot of brain power, a lot of horsepower is going into this, into creating this, in a relatively short period of time. But I don't see any point screwing around with it. I don't go back, as you notice, and rewrite scenes and sort of, I don't know, lovingly pick over them as I write, because I don't want to get too attached to anything. I just want to feel like this is the proper next stepping stone to get me where I need to go, and very importantly, that we are in structurally good shape. Now, I've had a couple of people say to me, oh, you know, there's something called the vomit draft. And I have to say, I think that's complete BS, because I don't know how you look at a pile of vomit and then reconstruct it or construct it into a steak. You need to have something that, you need to start with something that fundamentally looks like a steak. And so what we've done here is we've gotten a piece of marble or clay. And now we're going to, and it sort of roughly looks like a human being, and now we're going to go in and start chiseling and start refining some of those features. And then we'll do it one more time, and then we'll really refine it. But this concept of vomiting just all your ideas out, it makes no sense to me, because then you have an unformed mass, which is only more confusing than anything else you can have, because how do you take an unformed mass and give it structure? It sounds like an impossible task to me. To me, structure has to be the first thing you take into consideration, because structure is the dramatic structure, the dramatic construction is the storytelling. And, you know, the way that you express it within that structure and dramatic construction is really just the details, and then that comes down to artistry. you know, how well you can execute those details. But without the structure, you have nothing. And again, if you just have this sort of mess of ideas, I can't even imagine the difficulty it would be to take those mess of ideas and pick and choose them and then construct them into a structure. Ideas are not a movie. There are scenes are not a movie. Structure is a movie. There's turning points, these big turning points, the escalation of events, of stakes. That is a movie. Always good movies. They always escalate in stakes. They always have strong structure. So anyway, that's where we are. We're day 13, Fortunate Son. We've gotten the heavy lifting. We've got the block of marble that is roughly shaped into what it's going to be. And now again, we're going to go back, Mr. Beginning Monday morning, and I'm going to start doing a bit more fine cutting on the scenes. I don't think they're going to change a lot. There's a few that I need to add. I already know that. And I need to, it's about 118 pages right now. I know I need to shrink it by 10 pages, because this should be running around 107 pages, 108 pages. Ideas have value, and some ideas have more value than others. A sort of action film of this genre, you know, which is, and there I chose it because these are commercial genres that if you decide to write one, you can actually go out and sell it. You know, it's not some sort of period drama or romance or something like that. We're going to reduce the size of it, we're going to sharpen everything, we're going to make it more economical and prettier. And I want to say I like the fact that I'm at 118 pages because I like being challenged, that I know I need to get it out to down to 107 or below possibly, because having restrictions and walls forces me to make tough choices as I'm going along. I cannot do just whatever I want. I need to do what I think is right and what's good, but I also need to obey certain boundaries. And so I think for those of you who will watch along or will read the final script and say, gee, how was that accomplished? You'll go back and you'll find this next process quite interesting. But they are very separate processes. There's three processes. The first one, which I just did, which is the heavy lifting. Again, assembling the block of clay. The next one is beginning the cutting, the real cutting. Although it's already cut to a certain degree, the real cutting begins next week. And again, it's going to be depressing for me as shit. But then the third week, when I start doing fine cutting, my mood will suddenly change and I'll be very happy because, theoretically, I will be able to really see the light at the end of the tunnel. I'll be able to feel the script coming alive in my hands. And so that's very quite a joyous process for me. So that's where we're at. Fortunate Son, day 13. And that's all she wrote. I'll see you Monday.